In this Herschel Science Centre short video tutorial, we shall inspect the content of a SPAR spectrometer observational context. Each SPAR spectrometer observation is packed within a special container called the observational context. The context contains the different processing levels, from the raw data at level 0 to the highest pipeline process level of level 2. Level 2.5 or level 3 do not exist for the SPAR spectrometer. The context also includes the calibration tree and the ancillary products. These are only needed for running the pipeline or for reprocessing the observation. The quality control information is also part of the observational context, as well as some other useful products like the browse image, also known as the postcard image. All the products at level 2 are SARS ready, with some caveats, which are explained in detail in the Quick Start Guide to Herschel SPAR. Now let's have a look within an observational context. For illustration purposes, we have downloaded a full observational context from the Herschel Science Archive. Usually, it would suffice to download only the relevant Level 2 products. The content of Level 2 depends on the observing mode, sparse or mapping. The two modes can be easily distinguished by the postcard image, an image for mapping, and a spectrum for sparse mode. The products from the archive are packed in a tar archive file. Unpacking the tar file will create a folder structure with the observational context hierarchy. For sparse mode, we have the spectra for each of the two calibration schemes, point or extended. Each spectrum also has a smooth version via apodization in Fourier space. If the observation was taken in high plus low resolution mode, then there will also be spectra for both spectral resolutions. Each of the level 2 subfolders contains a single compressed FITS file with the corresponding spectra for the detectors from the two spectrometer bands, SSW and SLW. Each detector spectrum is stored in a table as a separate FITS extension. The names and the positions of the detectors are shown in the hexagonal representation of the two detector arrays. The detector FITS extension is a table with the frequency in gigahertz, the flux, and its error, both in Jansky's, and the final number of scans that were averaged to produce the final spectrum. For historical reasons, the frequencies column is called wave. Note that the unaveraged spectra are available through the Herschel Science Archive as highly processed data products. In the mapping mode, hyperspectral cubes are built by repeating the sparse mode pattern on 4 or 16 predefined positions, called jiggle positions. These are the intermediate or full spatial sampling modes. The individual spectra from all the detectors are then projected on a regular sky grid, and this is your resulting spectral cube. The same patterns are repeated for raster mode, but over a different set of telescope pointings. The level 2 products contain cubes for each of the two spectral bands, SSW and SLW. Cubes produced by two different methods of projection of the individual spectra are also provided: naive projection and convolution. Each of these two cubes per band has a version using the apodized spectra for the projection. And for completeness, the individual spectra at each of the 4 or 16 positions are provided as a two-dimensional table. Products with the words Spectrum 2D in the name. Each of these subfolders contains a single multi-extension FITS file. The FITS file stores the hyperspectral cube as a 3D image together with the error cube and the coverage. The individual spectra for each jiggle and raster position are stored as a 2D table in the first FITS extension. The individual spectra can be useful when one wants to avoid averaging or convolving of spectra. Note that the individual spectra, as well as the hyperspectral cubes, are science-ready products. A README file at the uppermost level explains the content of the TAR archive file from the Herschel Science Center. You may notice that there are some additional files in the subfolders, XML and FITS files. These are special files used by the Herschel Interactive Processing Environment, HIPE. And the postcard figure, also known as the browse image, is available within the Observational Context folder. An alternative and more advanced and user-friendly way to inspect the observational context is to use the Herschel Interactive Processing Environment. There are different ways to load an observational context in HIPE. These are explained in another tutorial. Here, I will only briefly illustrate how an observational context looks in HIPE. In HIPE, we have access to the same structure as the folders, but in addition, we also have access to a command line console and to different applications and interactive tools linked to the various product types. These are called tasks. And even more, we have access to advanced tools for interactive spectral analysis and spectral line and continuum fitting. Similarly, for hyperspectral cubes, we have access to an advanced toolbox specially developed for Herschel spectral cube products. The use of some of the HIPE interactive tools is presented in other video tutorials.